60 years ago, boys, I rode for the Diamond Team. Sailing by 8 feet high on horses quick as dreams.
Hi, my name's Roland Millington, and this is Backyard Horsemanship. It's a rather windy day in Illinois, so hopefully you'll still be able to hear me through all this. Now, this here's Thunder, and many of you guys have seen me do a lot of this with Rio, and I've actually had a couple people that have messaged me offline and said, what do I do when my horse is really tall? Well, Thunder is 16'1", okay, so he's not extremely tall. You know, he's not like he's a 17'4", he's not like he's a 17'2", 17'3", thoroughbred or something like that. But at the same time, there are two things you can do with a horse that is larger than you if you're going to try this method. Number one, trade him in for a smaller horse. Or number two, get some help, either from a bucket or from another person to be able to help leg you up. If you're going to get another person, the other person has to be there for the entire process so the horse becomes desensitized. Now, Thunder's looking at all the grass, so he's going to be the perfect candidate for this as to what happens when your horse isn't paying any attention, okay? And Thunder's very willful, and he's very stubborn in many instances, but once it breaks over in him, he calms down, relaxes, he'll put his head down and get the grass that he wants, okay? Because he's been allowed. It's very important that you either allow your horse or don't allow your horse when you're doing this process. So if I tell him head up, and he doesn't, I need to go to the hip. And he knows exactly what happens when I go to the hip, okay? All right, so what we're going to do right now is we're going to work with Thunder a little bit on keeping his head up first and foremost. We're going to get him faced up. Thunder knows what this means, and he knows it means turn his hip off. So, hip, 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 hip. There's a lot of respect there, okay? He knows I can direct him in a circle, I can direct him in an arc, I can push him straight back. You know, he knows where my space is and where his attention span has to be. So the next step, and you wouldn't, you know, you'd go through a lot of the other processes of the jumping up and down next to him, the half mounts and stuff like that. The next steps would be to get on the horse's back, get yourself slid Superman style all the way to where you're coming off either side equally, and then you're eventually coming straight off the rump and the horse is just so relaxed he won't move, okay? Now, when you're doing this on a larger horse, you either have a bucket here that they're desensitized to. You can pick this thing, they check it out, they're interested in it, they sometimes put their head down, try to eat the grass, you know, they're not too worried about it. So the next step would simply be this. Bring the bucket up next to your horse, okay? Make sure he's gonna stand for you. You got that head tilted in a little bit. You can jump up and down, and you're gonna mount up and across. Just as simple as that. A lot of petting, get the head up. If he's not gonna face up, get his head up. Let him know that he's still gotta pay attention. If he decides to step off, you block a little bit. If he decides to put his head down, just get him to where he keeps his head up, make it as low key as possible. You gotta have good timing, good feel, and good release. There'll be horses that'll test you like this. They'll wanna get in on you. They'll wanna put their heads down. They'll figure I can just flick a cigarette and not have to worry about this. I can go off to the five and dime store and buy myself some candy. You don't want that. What you want is that horse to slowly and surely, as minimally as possible, redirect his energy and his focus back up on you to where he understands my job when mounting is to stand stock still, okay? So, once again, we'll go back to the mounting block. I'll throw the rope over. He knows his head's his responsibility is to keep his head off to the side, and he's testing me with this. He's leaning his shoulder into me. So I'm going to rock him square. There. Okay. I'm going to put my bucket right back where it needs to be. I'm blocking his downward movement, and he's testing. He's testing. He's like, do I really need to be here? Do I really need to stop? He's pushing that bucket around, and I'm going to push him back off. And I'm going to push him back off, and I'm going to rock him square out of my space. There. That's his determination to stay square. He's got his head up. bucket. If he continues to test, I'll go to the hip. Let him know. He goes to move off, not seeing a square, go to that hip. I go to that hip, block his face out of my way. I don't care where that bucket goes. Block his face out of my way. Move those feet. Okay? Bring his shoulder on across. Walk him around. Go to that hip and send it out there. Let him realize he's got to stand still, okay? That's what you do when your horse doesn't move, or your horse wants to move his feet, and he's bigger than you are, and you can't mount up unless you're on that block. You block first in little bumps with the head, okay? You give him a little pressure for him to step back off of to where he keeps his head good and level. And then if that doesn't work, you go to that hip and you face him back up, okay? Hopefully, you've done a lot of that face up, which I haven't with Thunder. I wanted you to see exactly what had happened. If you haven't done your face up, that's how you fix it. And you go right back to facing up. Go back to moving the shoulders over. Go back to walking him around. Go back to sending that hip, sending that hip. Get real effective with it, okay? Bring that shoulder over, bring that shoulder over. Send that hip, face him up. It's just that simple. All right, that's backyard horsemanship, and that's how you mount a horse that's larger than you are, that's taller than you'd be able to vault up onto on, and you can use a mounting block, you can use another person to leg you up if you're not quite tall enough to be able to vault up onto the horse's back. And you use little bumps of that lead rope, okay, maintain that pressure until he gets off the pressure. If he decides to try to put his head down and ignore you, you're going to do the same thing. If he continues to do that, you're going to do the exact same thing. Send his hip off and face him back up and get him square with you again. Good luck, and I'll see you next time.